She is a freelance writer by day and the founder of New England Independent Writers. She is a self-published author with 3 sci-fi books and one children's book. She's been writing since she was a child, and in her free time, she likes to go swing dancing and explore in the woods. So without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, Ariele Sieling.
By taking a quick poll. Raise your hand if you own an e-reader of some sort. An iPhone, a Kindle, a Nook, an iPad, tablet. Most of you, I would hope, at this point. Second question. Raise your hand if in the last year you have downloaded and read a book on your e-reader. Excellent. Glad to see so many readers in the audience. Last question. Raise your hand if after reading the book, you went online and wrote a review. Thank you. most people don't. An interesting statistic says that less than 10% of people who purchase a product will go online and review that product. But somewhere between 72 and 90% of people will use online reviews to decide whether or not to purchase a product. That means that less than 10% of people are influencing how 72% of people choose to spend their money. I think that's a pretty significant statistic. So, does it really matter if you write a review of a book or a blender or anything? I think it matters, and I think it matters a lot. Thank you. Everybody tells stories. I tell stories. This is a picture of me with one of my books. You tell stories via Instagram, Facebook, you know, whatever your medium of choice is. Parents and teachers tell stories, politicians tell stories, even the news tells stories. The stories are just words on paper or on a computer screen until somebody reads it, shares it, criticizes it, or gives it a minute of their time. And the stories that get the most support from the community, those are the stories that end up making a difference. At New England Independent Writers, we're all about stories. Our goal is to support independent storytelling by the medium of books. And our vision is to help writers, local writers, who are dedicated and strong, rise to the top of the independent publishing industry. What this means for us is that we're constantly looking for opportunities to find ways for the authors, local authors, to connect to the local community. We do this in a variety of ways. We might put together an anthology of short stories by local authors. We might go to local events and festivals. We might give presentations like I'm giving right now. But the goal is to help authors find support and the criticism that they need to tell stories that are worth telling. What this means for you is that you have direct access to some of the best storytellers in the community. You can help influence what stories are told, and you can influence what stories end up making the difference. I spent a lot of time talking to people in the community, librarians in particular, trying to find ways that local authors can connect with and give back to the local community. I would venture to say that connecting with the community, particularly for authors, is one of the most difficult and probably the most important things that they can do. And I'm going to demonstrate with a story. Once upon a time, there was a guy I met who wanted to be a writer, so he wrote a book. He self-published it on Amazon. He got one review. It was from his mom. nobody knows who he is. He didn't get any community support. But he continued. He wrote 2 more books, and no one still knows who he is. I'm going to tell a different story. Well, let me clarify that. His book was bad. It was poorly written, violent. It was bad. Once upon a time, there was another guy who wanted to be a writer. He wrote a book, self-published on Amazon. He got dozens of reviews. He wrote more stories, lumped them all together into one book, and now he's a millionaire. This is Hugh Howey, author of the popular dystopian book, Wolf. So, what's the difference? aside from the quality of the writing. They're both, you know, they both want to be writers, they both self-published, they both wrote more books. The difference starts with telling a story that's worth telling. One of the stories is obviously not worth telling. But it takes off when it gets community support. Most authors that I know are somewhere between these two writers. I don't personally know any self-published millionaires, but I know plenty of authors who are either making a living from writing or supplementing their income pretty significantly. But there are still plenty of stories out there that are worth telling that are lying dormant because their authors or their writers don't know how to connect with and access the community. Every good story starts as an idea, as words on paper, as an empty canvas, or as a simple photograph. And then it needs community, it needs resources, and it needs time to grow. So if you find a story that you love, I encourage you to find a way to support it, whether that means donating money, giving your time and skill set to help the story have a larger impact, or sharing it with friends and family. It's like voting, except that instead of one vote, you get as many votes as you're willing to put the time and energy into casting. So why not start by writing a review? Thank you.